Welcome to Artix 8-Bit Bytes, where we talk about AV programming. Let's talk about an interesting subject. Let's do a Crestron versus QSC Qsys discussion. Is the day of the high-paid programmer gone? First off, I've been a Crestron programmer for many years. So whenever I work with another platform, I'm going to compare it to my experiences with Crestron. Crestron has been the gold standard for many years. So let's compare a few things back and forth between the two. Let's start on the Crestron side. Crestron's main programming interface is called Simple Windows. Simple Windows is somewhat of a drag and drop block type programming interface. Crestron also has several deeper layers of programming. It has Simple Plus, which is a C-style programming language. And there's also even a deeper level called C#. If you program in Simple Plus, you still use Simple Windows as a base. And the Simple Plus C code appears as a block in Simple Windows. The thing about Crestron programming is that its programming folder has a bunch of different files. When you do a final compile of your program, Simple Windows takes all those files and compiles it into a single binary file. You then upload that single file to the control processor. Once this file has been uploaded, you cannot decompile the Crestron program without having the original source files. You can pull that binary file off the processor to load onto another processor, but you can't make changes to the program without having the original files. Back in the day, highly paid Crestron programmers would play the game of keeping those files and forcing the client to go back to the original programmer for more work. And eventually, smarter clients would start to ask the programmer for those files. That way they could hire other programmers down the road to make the changes. Now, it is pretty common practice now, however, for Crestron programmers to hand over the code after they finish a programming job. For Crestron training, it can take between 1 to 3 years to become a fully certified programmer. You used to have to take all the courses in person and submit examples of your programming to get into the next class. Crestron now has provided some of this training online. Now, let's switch over to that same topic with Qsys. Qsys uses a program called Qsys Designer. Designer is a drag and drop interface that allows you to drop in programming blocks and connect the dots between blocks with wires and name tags. Designer also has two deeper levels of programming, all based around the Lua scripting language. One way is with an easy to learn blocky type programming language called Block Controller. And the other way is with another block called Text Controller, in which you are allowed to use the Lua scripting language, both of which allow deeper levels of programming past the basic drag and drop structure. The beauty of Qsys is that once you load the program onto the processor, you can grab that program back off the processor, make changes, and then load the new changes back on. The programming language called Lua is a scripting language. And the amazing thing about Lua scripting is that you can make changes to your Lua scripts in real time while the program is still running. For Qsys training, QSC introduced an online video training series several years ago. The training was lighthearted, had a lot of humor, and proved to be an easy way to learn the Qsys platform. You now can become Level 1 certified in under a week. They also just recently released over 100 new videos, including detailed videos of how to learn Lua scripting. You now can learn a lot more without ever having to attend in-person training. All of that stuff is now available online. The next big difference between the two platforms, Qsys was originally designed as an audio DSP. It has many of the same features as a Biamp Tessera, a Symmetrix, or a BSS London. When Qsys first came out, we would use Qsys as an audio DSP and use Crestron as a logic processor. QSC is an open platform that allows other control processors to communicate with it easily. With Crestron, we would usually have to pair a processor with an external audio DSP. Now, Crestron does make their line of Crestron DMPSs, and they also have their own line of audio DSPs. However, using an external third-party audio DSP was usually the way to go. Having a built-in audio DSP, like in the case with Qsys, has greatly simplified the audio programming side of things. One nice little feature with Qsys Audio is that you can easily get live audio meters on a touchscreen. Now, let's talk about video. Crestron has their fantastic line of Crestron NVX video over IP boxes. And just recently, they have even released an HDMI wall plate version of NVX. The other huge benefit of NVX is cost. The NVX D10 and E10 line of encoders and decoders are some of the least expensive video over IP boxes you can buy. But for the price, they work great in a lot of applications. With NVX being completely expandable, you can add an inexpensive Crestron RMC4 control processor and have an economical way to have a huge matrix video system. Crestron has always had the edge when it comes to video quality and video endpoint stability. Their video has always been rock solid and will run for years with very little maintenance. QSC also has video over IP boxes. They originally worked with a company called Visionary Solutions. Visionary Solutions makes an excellent line of video encoders and decoders. They also make several HDMI wall plate versions. Qsys and Visionary Solutions had created several drag and drop modules, making complex video programming easy. This past 2 years, Qsys has also decided to make their own line of video over IP boxes. Currently, the NV32 and the NV21 both have multiple inputs and can work as a standalone local video switcher, along with the capability to stream AV to other endpoints. Their boxes can work in either encoder or decoder mode. The NV32 can also double as a Qsys Core processor, and you need to buy the Core mode license for it. But the NV32s and the NV21s, though great products, do come in at a much higher price point. So, let's talk a little bit about cameras and USB. When using Crestron NVX, Crestron allows you to route USB 2.0 between NVX encoders and decoders. Qsys has taken this a step farther. Qsys has a line of PTZ cameras. Their core processors and their NV32 all have USB 3.0 connections on them. You can connect their cameras via a network cable to the control network of the control processor. The software can then be programmed to connect the dots between that camera and a USB 3.0 output. This makes routing USB from a camera in the room to a rack computer, or even a bring your own device computer, super easy. Having integrated cameras in the Qsys environment also makes it extremely easy to control the Qsys cameras from a touchscreen. It's also easy to get a live preview from a Qsys camera onto the touchscreen. So what about reliability? I believe that both platforms are extremely rock solid. I've had a few Crestron systems that have been running nonstop now for over 10 years. I also have Qsys systems in the field running flawlessly for many years now also. What does this mean for the AV programming industry? AV programming is now easier to learn, and the code easier to maintain. AI is also making it easier to dig for information that used to be very hard to find. AI can also help you debug code. It can help you study programming routines and ways to simplify your code. AI can even take code written in one language and convert it to another. And at the very least, it can point you in the right direction. There will always be clients that may require a more experienced programmer here and there. And they're probably going to be willing to pay a little bit more for their expertise. But us as programmers, I think in the future we will have to diversify and become better engineers. There will always be a need for someone to test, deploy, and edit, like on the engineering side. But I believe the days of the highly paid elite programmers are quickly disappearing. Programming will be easier to learn, information will be easier to obtain, and certifications will be obtained more quickly. And AI will be filling in the gaps where we fall short. So don't tell anyone, but did you know that Microsoft Copilot can program Qsys Lua and Crestron Simple Plus? Silence there. It may get a lot of things wrong, but it certainly can help you debug a flawed program. And it can also help you with syntax. It's basically time to step up to the plate and welcome the new era of programming and programmers. Either we get on board or we need to step out of the way. It will be interesting to see what happens to the Crestron versus Qsys debate in the future. But I'm going to guess that the platform that is easier to program, easier to deploy, and easier to manage by IT managers is going to be the one that's going to be gaining a lot more popularity in the future.